You're watching the free version of Silhouette Essentials. For projects and footage, head to borisfx.com for the premium download.
Okay, let's do one more marker on the screen up here. And let's do one on the left side. Let's work on this marker here. So since it gets obstructed by her hand, by both hands, I'm going to track the marker out here. And I'll use that tracking for this marker. So go ahead and make a new layer. First, I'm going to lock my other layer here. And Shift C, I'll have the circle shape. Click 2, so I can see the foreground and track in this mode, which is actually faster. And we'll go to the tracker tab, Shift T, and we're already selected on the Mocha Tracker and translation, and we're just going to track. Okay, so now this track is done. And while I might not need to clean this marker out, it's nice to have some clean tracking data. So another thing to look at here is like, you think, how far do I have to clean out if I made a GMAT? You can click on the Roto node and you can kind of see, okay, kind of look at it this way, how far you have to clean out. And another way to do that is to use an additional viewer. So if I click the plus button here, I get another viewer and I can just nestle that into the side here. I'm going to zoom in and I'm going to put this on Roto node 2. And we can look at the different views, but I'm just going to press 4, which is the color comp. And now that's just an easy way to see, okay, if I'm here, how much do I actually have to clean? Okay, so then I'm just going to close this for now. But you can leave that open while you work. And we'll go back to the Inpaint node here. So I have my marker here. I'm going to call that upper marker far screen left. And then I'm going to duplicate this. So I'm just going to lock this. I'm going to click the multi-frame tool, first get into the Roto editing tool here, M, and I'm going to go to a frame where I can see the marker, and I'm just going to move this over. And I'll click 2, and now you can see that the marker's filled, or it's disappeared, and I'm going to click M to get out of the multi-frame mode. We have no more red border, and just see how this looks. So it's moving around a little bit, but it looks like the marker is obscured. Now I'm going to go in and do my animating of the shape. First, I'm going to name this upper marker screen left. Zoom in a little bit. Get into the Roto editing mode. So I'm just going through the shot, changing my shape, making some edits, toggling the opacity on and off, and making sure it's off when it's in the motion blurred areas, especially over the hand, because you don't want a marker mixed in with the motion blur in the hand. So you want to just get the most procedural application out of this as much as possible, and leave the hand paint for the last thing. Next, I'll take a look at the floor and tackle some areas there. Okay, we're zoomed out now and we can see the floor, and we'll just play that through. I'm going to pick a tracking marker or some tape to paint out. I think I'm going to focus on this marker right here. I'm going to turn on my Roto to make sure that that's in the area that needs to be painted, and it is. So let's work on that. I'll go back to the Inpaint node. I'm going to zoom in. And the way the camera moves in this shot, there's a little distortion at the edge of frame. So our tracking's probably going to need a little more help than just translation. So we'll go to the first frame, go to the tracking tab, Shift T, and make a shape. I'm just going to use a B spline here. Click B. Make a shape around the marker. Back to the tracking tab and make sure that translation, scale, and rotation are checked, and we'll track the shot. Okay, it looks like the tracking broke around here. We're just going to go to the timeline and delete the frames that aren't working anymore. So it breaks around here. And just delete the bad frames. And I'm going to set a keyframe here by pressing Alt Option. And then move my shape off the screen. Go back a few frames to see if that's animating correctly, and it looks just fine. So now let's take a look to see what the fill looks like. I'll press 1 to go to the output, and I'll turn off the overlays by clicking 0 on the keyboard. And that looks good. I might need a tiny paint touch-up at the front of the toe here for a couple frames, but otherwise that part is done. Okay, I'm just going to choose one more little area to clean. We'll zoom in here. And I'm going to choose these two dots here. While that seems like it should just be an easy paint fix, it's actually a little more challenging because the shadows of the legs and the feet go over it, and so that might interrupt the tracking a bit. And let's see how this works. I'm going to create a new layer, click B for B spline. I'm going to make a shape around the two dots here. And I'm just going to use translation. I don't want to complicate the track with scale and rotation. So we'll just start the tracking now. And it looks like it breaks right when the pant leg just sort of goes over that area. There's a shadow change. And so we could spend a lot of time trying to get a perfect track, but we're just going to figure this out manually. I'm going to make a keyframe at the last good frame. Alt Option in the timeline, and then I'm going to delete that bad data. And then we'll just manually track the rest. Okay, I think that's going to be good enough. So let's see how the Inpaint works. I'm going to press 2 or press 1 to see the fill, and we're going to press 0 to turn off the outline. So it's, you see there's some popping here because the fill is taking from the outside of the shape. And just depending on where the shape is, it's pulling in from all these different areas as the edge of the shadow moves through the shape. And you can kind of see a ghosting of the dots in here anyway. Let's just turn on the overlays again. And I'd probably have to make my shape a little bit bigger. Press M for multiframe. I don't want to move the shape. I just want to kind of move the points out. And we're still having the same problem. So I'm going to try a different method. And instead of using this algorithm, I'm going to use the clone method. So we're going to go to the clone, pull down here. And we're going to see how we can make that work. So I'm going to just scroll down to see these parameters. And we're going to move the offset and the rotation. So let's just start at the end and we'll find an area that we want to clone from. And as I move these numbers here, you can see that this dotted line is going to represent where we're cloning from. And I'm just going to turn off the overlay and just do a quick scrub through. It's kind of working, but still needs a little help. First, I'm going to move these points in. I'm going to press M. Press 2 again. Maybe I don't need such a big shape. And since we have different keyframes in the timeline, I always want to make sure I'm pressing M for multiframe when I'm making shape adjustments, if I want these shape adjustments to be for the whole shot and to be consistent. And another thing I'm going to do here is that I'm going to add a little bit of softness to the outside of the shape. If you scroll up here, we only have edge softness and not smoothness. So I'm just turn off the overlays. And I might want a little more softness on the edge. And to do that, you can feather the edge itself. So if I'm just going to play around with this number here, you can see that's not really doing what I want it to do. It's kind of going from edge softness to hard to really feathered, but I still need coverage. So I'm going to have to move my edge softness to closer to zero, and then I'm going to have to feather the edge because I don't have any other way to do it. There isn't the option to blur individual shapes in the Inpaint node. So I'll go back to the overlays. I'm going to just select these points here, Alt F to enable the feathering. And I'm just going to see if that's going to work. But I just realized now I'm not in multiframe. Click multiframe and pull out the feather. Okay, we'll turn off the overlays again. And I can see I have a little more softness, but I might want even more. Okay, let's go with that. If I see some hard edges on the lower part of the shape, I can just fix those when we get to working on those parts of the range. Now we have to work on our translations here. So go back to the transform and let's find a frame that's working. So if this is working, just about working, we'll have to move this in. We might have to do some animating here. All right, so I'm going to set a keyframe here. And we'll see how long we can use this offset. It looks good to about here. I'm going to set another keyframe, Alt, here. And then we'll move to where it doesn't work. So now we have to change our offset if I turn on the overlays. So where can I move this so it will work for this shape here? I'm going to move this down, click zero. Okay, that looks pretty good. And we'll just scrub in between. All right, that looks fine. And now I'm going to just set another keyframe here. And then when it starts breaking again, we'll move the offset, click zero. I'll turn off the overlays so I can kind of see what I'm doing. Okay, that's pretty good. It's kind of lining up with this area here. And then we'll move to the next part where it doesn't look good here. So this might seem like it takes a long time, but it's still faster than hand painting. Using the clone option is a good alternative once you get used to how you can use it. You can set keyframes for any of the translation parameters such as offset, rotation, and scale, and see your results frame by frame. You can have some control over edge softness and feathering for blending areas a bit better. And this example is definitely a little bit one of the more complicated ones. And you can also keyframe with grading if you need it. So while this might seem like I'm doing tons of adjustments, it will help minimize any paint touch-ups. Auto paint with cloning would not have been a good approach here due to the crisscrossing of shadows that move across the white dots. And then we don't need our shape anymore. We can just use the opacity keyframes and turn it off. So now that some parts of the floor are worked on, I'm just going to zoom out here. And we'll do some manual paint in the paint node.